Holmes, we need to help poor Tom.
Come on, Toby.
It's time for you to earn your keep.
Watson?
I prefer to visit Lord Marsh. I'm worried about the condition of his health. Search, Toby. Search.
Nothing that could interest me. Old things. Ordinary storage. Tom's photograph. Let's try to get inside. A map of Epping Forest. This case must have been full of cartridges. News clippings on Lords in the education program. Why are they here? Let's compare this list with the evidence that we found earlier. This is the list of selected participants for October's special education program. According to this poster, John Strobridge is missing. Let's compare them with people from Hearst documents. This man appears in both documents. All the people in Marsh's document are marked and dated in George Hurst's files. Rubbish. Pile of rubbish. Just some old things. Brave Toby, best nose in the British Empire. Brave Toby, the best nose in the British Empire. Brave Toby, best... Brave Toby, best nose in the British Empire. Brave Toby, best nose in the... People use this cellar for storage. It's not here. Old things. Brave Toby, the best nose in the British Empire.
Just leave the post on the doorstep. Just leave the post on the doorstep. A collection of worn-out and second-hand books. George Hurst was providing his son with the best education that he could afford.
Please, sir, find my father.
Brave Toby, best nose in the British Empire.
Just some old...
There was something on the stand.
There was a rifle here. George Hurst took it with him.
Holmes, what are you doing here? What are you planning?
A mission of my own. You must play the role of the conscientious doctor while I sneak inside Marsh's house. That's the only way of helping little Tom.
This is not the best way to sneak in. The window is firmly shut.
Can I help you?
I came to visit Lord Marsh.
What for?
I would very much like to see Lord Marsh, if you please.
Oh, you're so clumsy. Can you please not...
I have to visit Lord Marsh and offer him my services.
Fisher, please allow Dr. Watson to enter.
Good job, Watson. I can hide here. Let's see how hard to crack this safe is.
Doctor, it appears that you were impatient to pay me another visit.
Indeed. Will you allow me to examine you? A second opinion, so that the great Lord Marsh does not become the late Lord Marsh.
Since you put it that way, very well.
Shall I retire to your office, Lord Marsh?
No, please, Doctor. I insist that you stay. I shall need your assistance.
Will you break anything else?
I'll try my best.
Thank you.
November 7th. This means that the meeting is planned for today. I have to finish my search of the office. Lord Marsh is a keen hunter.
I'd suggest that your current weakness is perhaps more than a simple case of influenza, Lord Marsh.
Where might your companion be, Dr. Watson?
Oh, he's busy poking his nose into other people's business, I'm sure.
My lord, I'm sorry to interrupt, but I must remind you about your meeting.
Is it already time? My apologies, Dr. Watson, but we are expected elsewhere. Might we offer you a lift?
You are going out? I'm not sure that's wise in your condition.
I value your opinion, but misery never rests, and I am needed.
Well, do please take good care of yourself, Lord Marsh. I'll send you my diagnosis, Dr. Fisher.
Thank you, Dr. Watson. Farewell.
Holmes, come here. This is serious.
Well, well. Sweet slumber after a hard working day. On my pillow. Watson, what are you doing at my table?
I just need to check one thing about Lord Marsh. My intuition tells me that Lord Marsh is hiding something about his disease. His cough, in addition to his fever and his usage of strong painkillers, leads me to believe that he is seriously ill. Let's study it more closely. sputum with tiny drops of blood. I could take a sample and examine it under the microscope. I need to take a sample of it using the glass rod. Let us apply chemicals to color the sample. I need a pipette. I need a pipette. I need a pipette. This chemical should be applied third. This chemical should be applied second. Now, let's examine the colored sample under the microscope. Mycobacterium. It appears that Lord Marsh is seriously ill. Holmes, this is no longer a laughing matter. It is just as I feared. Lord Marsh is suffering from tuberculosis.
You don't say.
Yes, I do say. And Holmes, he will die if he is not transferred to a sanatorium as soon as possible.
And yet both Lord Marsh and Dr. Fisher are doing their best to hide this fact. How interesting.
But why?
Why indeed, Watson?
Oh, but... oh, dear God. You don't think that Lord Marsh contracted tuberculosis while aiding the poor? How terrible. I have a commitment that I can't possibly cancel. Holmes, during my absence, please be extremely careful. This disease is highly contagious. And remember that we have women at home.
Thank you, Miss Alice. Until later.
I'll see you soon, Caitlin.
Where have you been?
Our neighbour lent me a book. She is so kind. I think she likes you.
I doubt that.
How is your investigation going?
It's going. Dracula?
Yes. It's forbidden reading at my boarding school. Did you know?
Well, well.
It is thrilling.
Here it is.
Cranston's Oak is in Epping Forest. That's the place indicated on George Hurst's map.
My friends about this.
Let's try to find the place from the hand-drawn map. Here it is. Drat! I'll need to hurry if I want to find out what's going on at the forest.
Father, that boy Wiggins, does he come here very often?
He helps occasionally in some of my cases. Why do you ask?
I'd like to talk to him.
Talk to him?
Father, back at school there are only girls to talk to, and they are so boring. I'm sure Wiggins has lots of exciting stories to tell about his life in London. It would be so romantic.
Caitlin, you know that Wiggins hasn't had the most fortunate life.
That only makes him more interesting.
Oh, Kate.
I'll leave you alone now.
Let's see how long you can stay alive!
He was poor. This man was killed recently. The body is still warm.
Find him, boys! Find him! Where is he? Today! Walk of despair! You won't get far!
He was killed by a shot to the forehead. My God, it's Lord Harrington's body. My health is deteriorating. I need to dress my wound. Quartermain Club. This must be Lord Marsh's cabin. This will help to dress my wound. Someone's coming, I better hide.
Breathe, Lord Marsh. It's almost over.
Who are you?
George Erst from the First Lovett Scouts, here to deliver justice.
An old soldier. How ironic. Did we refuse you on our special education program?
It's true, I was refused. An old wounded soldier is useless to you, but he can still be dangerous.
We hunted a lot in these woods, but I didn't expect to become the prey. I have lived a grand life without any limits set by others. I will die a happy man, so you won't see me begging, you festering wretch.
Prepare to meet your maker.
George, lower your rifle, please, for Tom's sake.
Holmes! My, my. An almost worthy opponent.
Tom? My Tom? If you've endangered my lad in any way, you will pay dearly.
I assure you that Tom is safe in London with a well-trusted friend. And now it's time to end this.
By all means.
George Hurst, your bloodlust ends today. You should have been apprehended weeks ago, before you killed Strobridge out of jealousy. Drop your gun. You may have wounded me, but I won't miss you.
If I ever had you in my aim, I wouldn't have merely wounded you.
Oh, the best detective in England.
Detective, take a look here.
This is how you became sick, Lord Marsh. The beheading of your victims who were suffering from tuberculosis was what infected you. Poetic justice. I was wrong.
The best detective in England. Enough! You'll die here, Lord Marsh, and you'll die slowly.
Mr. Hurst, you've already served brutal justice to Lord Harrington, and I hope Lord Collins and Dr. Fisher. Taking that into consideration, you may as well kill Lord Marsh and end the Quartermain Club completely. No loose ends. George, lower your rifle, please, for Tom's sake.
Holmes! My, my. An almost worthy opponent.
Tom? My Tom? If you've endangered my lad in any way, you will pay dearly.
I assure you that Tom is safe in London with a well-trusted friend. And now it's time to end this.
By all means.
George, listen to me.
If you're seeking an apt punishment and vengeance, killing Marsh will give him exactly what he wants. He would die knowing that he had fulfilled his life through his absolute control of it.
But if you allow Marsh to live and be arrested, he will suffer a punishment far greater than you or I could deliver. His ball and chain will be the debilitating tuberculosis. It will drag him painfully and slowly to his demise behind bars.
You're mad! You're both mad!
Let's go and find Tom.
Not just yet. See, Lord Marsh, you will die here, although not by the gun. You'll die slowly.
Don't do this, George.
Detective, take a look here.
This is how you became sick, Lord Marsh. The beheading of your victims who were suffering from tuberculosis was what infected you. Poetic justice.
Holmes, you cannot fully understand why we helped so many and sacrificed a few. But don't let me die like this. Just kill me now.
Mr. Hurst, you've already served brutal justice to Lord Harrington, and I hope Lord Collins and Dr. Fisher. Taking that into consideration, you may as well kill Lord Marsh and end the Quatermain Club completely. No loose ends.
Yes! Well done, Watson!
Holmes, you're playing bowls? Indoors?
Not just any old bowls, Watson. Lawn bowling.
Seriously? With your injury? No. Mrs. Hudson is going to murder you.
Well, that's it for now. Time to go. Would you care to join me?
You're incorrigible. And where are we going, Holmes?
I'm participating in the final stage of the annual tournament held by the London Archaeological Institute's Bowling Club. It's an official invitation. I'll just need to dress suitably and then we can leave.
Holmes, are you really sure you want to wear that?
This? Everyone dresses like this at the club.
That should be a sight worth seeing. I only hope our charming neighbour won't spot you like that.
Who chased his own tail again? I should walk with you more often. My bag with lawn bowls for the upcoming tournament.
Mr. Holmes, you played very well yesterday.
I'm obliged to you, Sir Charles. I play many outdoor sports. That's the key to my success. My friend Dr. Watson has decided to join me.
Really?
Mr. Holmes, would you like to see the first prize? A rare stone Mayan Quiche calendar.
Mayan Quiche?
Indeed. Their legendary king, Tekun Umán, has his statue just behind you. Although this one is a cast metal copy.
That?
Well, since only members may enter the clubhouse, we have exhibited the calendar outside. Please explore.
Good luck, Holmes.
What a beautiful day for November.
What a spectacular season. The great tournament of the London Archaeological Institute's bowling club.
Ah, Mr. Holmes, are you ready to begin the final game?
Yes, let's start the final.